Hi guys, DC Breaks here on the DBS Institute channel. This week I have been exploring Ace Studio, which is a next generation AI synthesis engine designed for making realistic and expressive sounding AI powered vocals. You can use it for creating lead vocals, backing vocals, harmonies, choirs, even some creative sound design possibilities as well. It's very intuitive to use. You can simply combine MIDI data, type in the lyrics you want it to use, and then really dial in lots of different types of expression from breaths to formants to energy and tension to make some amazing sounding vocals. So let's jump in and see how it works. So when you first launch Ace Studio, you have a fairly familiar DAW style layout. You've got some transport controls at the top and a range area where there's two types of track. You've got an audio track, which behaves like an ordinary audio track, and then your singer track. This is where the AI singer will appear. You've then got a clip view at the bottom here, which we'll look at in more detail shortly, and then a number of menus on the left to browse through the singer library, the track control panel where you can control the AI singer in more detail, and then also a mixer tab as well. So let's go ahead and choose an AI singer. We can either search for one or we can use some of the tags to try and refine what it is that we're looking for. So you can browse by language. There's three natively supported languages, namely Chinese, English, and Japanese. You can also use tags such as female or pop or bright, for example, or however you want to browse according to the tags you want to use. And then you simply choose one of the models that appear at the bottom here. You can also actually create your own custom singer by uploading vocals. I believe you need about 30 songs worth of vocals to get an effective model, and then you can create your own custom voice model using AI as well. In the track control panel, we can tweak this model. So our singer is Bianca, but we can change the timbre and the style. By default, they're linked, but you can unlink these to create different sort of versions, if you like, of Bianca's singing style. And to make things even more customizable, you can also choose to take another voice seed, like so this one for Lien or Lien, I'm not too sure how you pronounce that. And again, you can change the characteristics of that model and create a mix. So this will be a mixture of both these two voice models, and then save that as a unique voice mix that you can use in your project. Finally, you have a mixer tab where you can control things like the pan and the gain of each of your channels. But first of all, we now need to go really in and start to look at how we create some vocals. So I'm going to right click to create a clip. And from here, I can start to add in MIDI notes and start applying lyrics to those notes. So I'm just going to click and hold to put in a note like this. And you can see by default, it's given it a simple dah. So this dah is one syllable. And for vocalists, we're applying one syllable per note. We can create longer held notes and we can play around with things a little bit, but you can't have overlapping notes because singers can't sing obviously more than one note at a time in the real world. Singers are effectively monophonic in that respect. And each syllable is split into its constituent phonemes. So if this singer is singing da, that's made up of a d and an r, and you can see these above the individual notes. So before I change anything, let's just hear how that sounds. I'm going to hit play. The AI model is going to synthesize this syllable, and then we will be able to hear it.
Da, da.
Okay, so you'll have noticed there's a little bit of a lag that can be a little bit off-putting when you're first starting, particularly if you're changing parameters, because every time you change a parameter, it has to resynthesize and render that vocal down. So let's go ahead and right click now and change the lyric to something that has more than one syllable, like the word hello. And again, because we can't have two syllables in one note, it's just applied the first syllable, the he, to this note. So if we want to have the rest of the word, we need to give it another note. So let's come up to F and put in a second note. Just going to right click on both of these now, and this will apply lyrics across those two notes, hello. So now we've got the hair and the low over here, and it's across two different notes. So let's hit play and hear how that sounds.
Hello.
Now, you might be able to hear actually that there is some reverb on this, and that's because one of the great features of Ace Studio is that it allows you to bridge into another DAW. So I'm actually using the bridge here with Logic, and all you do is you insert the Ace bridge as a software instrument. You can then apply different processing. So I've got this bus to some reverb, and then you'll be able to apply whatever processing you want to your vocal and hear it as you're working away in Ace Studio, which is a really nice, neat little feature. Within Ace Studio, there isn't any vocal processing tools, really. There's no EQ, compression, distortion and saturation, reverb, whatever you want. So you do need to do that within your another DAW. Now, what we can also do is to manipulate different aspects of these notes. So you can see this little grey line here is actually the pitch. So you can see here there's almost a bit of a glissando or a kind of slide between the first note and the second note. And because of the model that it's used, Bianca has this vibrato. It's then put in this vibrato on the sustain phase of this note as well. And we can change and manipulate all of this information. So if we come to the draw pitch control, for example, we could draw this in. So if we wanted to have it kind of really flat, we could do that. Or we could have it kind of doing something crazy like that if we wanted to. We can also use the pitch eraser tool if we make mistakes or just kind of want to get rid of stuff. And there's also a vibrato control. So you can see that there's some vibrato here, but we might want the whole thing to be vibrato. And we can change how much vibrato is being applied in terms of the amplitude, the frequency. So you can have it really slow or really fast. We can kind of shape the overall sort of attack and release, if you like, or like how quickly that kind of is being applied, like an envelope. We can control the phase as well in terms of when that vibrato is starting and the overall amplitude as well. Just going to undo that for now. We've also got the ability to change modulation overall. So at the moment, this is the pitch modulation that's being applied. But if I click and drag down, we can get rid of that entirely to make it completely flat. So almost like an auto-tune, like hard sort of pitch quantize, if you like, to a specific note. Or we can actually go the other way and sort of really emphasize that as well. But that's not all, because at the bottom, we can also control things like the breath, the air, falsetto, tension, energy, and formant. So for example, you know, real singers apply or add breaths when they're singing between words. They are human, they have to take breaths. So we can add those in to make this sound more realistic. We can control the air. And the air you can think of a bit like, almost like an EQ to an extent. So when it's kind of low, it is sort of more muted. And when it's high, it sounds more breathy and airy. We can see the amount of air that's sort of being played through these notes as it is at the moment. It's kind of coming up at the end. So we can either manipulate this by drawing in an envelope like so, as you would in most DAWs, or we can actually use straight lines to change the sort of gain, if you like, of the underlying signal like so. Or we can actually just use the parameter control and hard draw in different things, either as a straight line or as curves and things like that as well. Generally, the envelope sounds more natural, but let's go ahead and make this sort of really low air to start with, and then higher, and you should be able to hear the difference that makes to the performance. Then we've got falsetto. So falsetto, as you may be aware, is, I guess, forcing the pitch about up above the typical pitch range that you sing in, usually by an octave. There's also a tension control, so you can see the tension at the moment. Now, if I was being critical, I'd say that it doesn't really quite start with a more pronounced enough huh. You can see it's quite low here, so I might actually look to increase the tension and possibly also things like the energy, which is really how energetically the singer is singing right at the start, to kind of give that a bit more of a pronounced huh. Let's see if that works. So I kind of overdid that. It almost sounds like a sort of little pop or sort of a transient there. So a little bit of finessing required, but you can kind of smooth these things out. And then finally, there's a formant control as well. So the formant control really affects how or where the vocal's sitting in terms of the sort of main formant sound, so A, E, I, O, U. So if I put this up here, for example, and then bring it down low, you should be able to hear the vocal kind of ranging through those different sounds a little bit. So you can use that to correct different pronunciations or ways of saying particular sounds, or as a creative effect to kind of, you know, make sort of different pitch effects as well. But clearly creating an entire vocal line, let alone a whole song from scratch, putting in the notes and the lyrics, making sure everything's on the right notes in terms of the phonemes, and then kind of modulating and adding in all these different controls to really make that a realistic and lifelike performance, is a massive undertaking, and it's quite slow, particularly if you have to render each time to hear and sort of monitor all the changes that you're making. It you can't just do it in real time. But fortunately, Ace Studio has a number of very clever tricks up its sleeve in order to help you streamline the process of creating realistic vocals using an AI singer. So let's take a look at what you can do.
Hey everyone, I hope you've been enjoying this tutorial. At DBS Institute, we provide degree level training to help you take your skills to the next level and start your career in music production. Head to the link to find out more.
So one workflow that you can use is to import a guide vocal. So I'm going to be using a vocal hook from Splice, just because it's royalty free. I can use it in this video without any problems. Let's take a listen to how that sounds.
So call my name in the dark, doesn't really matter where you are.
Now you can hear that this is a already a wet vocal, but because it's running through Logic and the bridge, it's got like a double reverb on it. But what I'm going to do is now just click and drag this onto the singer track, and that's going to convert it. We can choose the language that we want, and then it's going to basically scan that, and not only is it going to pull out the MIDI data, it's also going to extract the lyrics, convert those into the relevant syllables and phonemes, and apply that. And what you get then is something that sounds a bit like this.
So call my name in the dark, doesn't really matter where you are, if you're near, are you far, I just want to feel you in my heart.
And so the beauty of this now is that we can use this as a model, if we like, and kind of go in and change any aspect of it, and it will just resynthesize it without really creating any artifacts, as it would as if we were doing normal vocal processing. So we could change this from "so call my name" to, let's change this to, let's go into lyrics, change, so call my bluff. Let's try that. That's a single syllable as well. Let's hear how that sounds.
So call my bluff in the dark.
And it just works astonishingly well. So we could right click all of this and, you know, change the lyrics to whatever we wanted, and then it would just sing those lyrics, but using that MIDI template, if you like, in terms of the notes. We could then start to move the notes around. We can transpose the whole thing up and down very simply. We can add in, of course, vibrato and things like that if we want to, change all of these other parameters, and almost think of it like a remixing tool. Now, if you can sing a little bit, which I can't, but I could, but maybe perhaps not on camera, sing a vocal line and then use that as a guide and very quickly get a vocal demo together as if I was a female vocalist that sounds perfect and exactly how I want it. And that's going to really speed up the process of me being able to create vocals for my tracks. So a slightly different workflow might involve working with the MIDI from scratch. So I'm going to bring in MIDI from the song Happy Birthday, which of course everyone knows. I'm just going to delete all of the tracks apart from the main melody, which in this case is Bells. Let's just get this onto the first note here and put this onto our singing track. I'm just working with Bianca again. Let's have a look at the MIDI information. We can see, once again, it's just got the default da, but it is the right melody, da, 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 da. And what I'm going to do now is just pitch this down because this is really high up. Let's get this down to a more like a C4 should do the trick. And again, because it was Bells originally, it's quite sort of short staccato notes. So I'm just going to click and drag these to make these longer. Now, at this point, it's not letting me take them any longer because we've got some overlapping notes here. Again, vocalists can't actually sing more than one note at the same time. So we just get this kind of grayed out or crosshatch area that shows that. And of course, we now need to change this to the right lyrics. So just in case you don't know the lyrics to Happy Birthday, you can look them up online. Here they are. And copy and paste these into our song. So I'm just going to select all of these, right click, edit lyrics, paste those in. And now we can see that it's applied those lyrics and the correct, hopefully correct, phonemes and syllables to each of the different notes. So it's happy birthday to you. And it's done that one syllable for every note. And if it hasn't done that right, we might need to shift them around a little bit. But let's take a listen and hear how that sounds.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, happy birthday, happy birthday to you.
So pretty good job. If we wanted to sustain some of these notes longer, dead easy to do that. So let's just really hold that to you here and see how that sounds.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday.
And so we can go in now and, as before, change the note durations. We can go in and work with all of these different settings as well, and maybe change the vibrato or the pitch where it's maybe not quite right. But otherwise, it's very, very, very powerful and quick to make really realistic sounding vocals using Ace Studio. Now, another nice little feature is how easy it is to make doubles. So in the real world, if this was our vocalist, we might have them sing this through several times, and each of those takes would be slightly different. And we could then layer those up to create a fuller, richer vocal performance. Now, if we did this in a studio, because it's going to synthesize it exactly the same every time, we wouldn't get that same effect. So what they've done is allow us to right click and create vocal doubles for a track. And then you can choose how similar the synthesis is from the original, between a range of 95% or 70%. So I'm just going to choose 70% so that they're very different, so we can easily see this. But if we look at the MIDI data, some of the notes are slightly before, some of them perhaps slightly after where they are in the original, some of them even sort of split up in different places. And then what it does automatically is it pans one hard left, one hard right. It's the same vocal model. And as a result, you then get this classic vocal doubling type of effect.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you.
Now, I chose 70%, so then perhaps a little bit too different. There's a few places where the notes are kind of not well aligned enough. But, you know, if you didn't like that, you could very easily just select these tracks, delete them, and create a different double that was more similar to the original. And then if you're happy with everything, you can hit export. You can then choose whether you want to export the entire master or individual selected tracks, whether they are mono or stereo, the format, whether that's MP3 or WAV, the sample rate and the bit depth. You then just need to give them a name, tell it where you want to export them, and you are done. So that is Ace Studio in a nutshell. The question is, can you see yourself using this in your own productions? Or perhaps the even bigger question, should you be using this in your productions? It raises quite a few interesting ethical questions around whether this technology might even pose an existential threat to vocal artists. It perhaps opens up the possibility of vocal artists being able to create their own custom voice models based off their own voices and possibly license that. Is that something that we're going to start to see both now and in the future? So this technology, undeniably powerful though it is, it does raise a lot of interesting questions about the direction of how we're going to be working with music technology both now and in the future. So let me know what you think in the comments below. Don't forget to hit that like and subscribe button to get more videos like this from us here at DBS, and I'll see you in the next one.